Hello there. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about the println function. So this function is actually a function that we decided to impose in many of the exercises in order to for learning purposes. So you will see that it's actually limiting in some ways, but it's in order for you to really understand Go at the more basic level and how string works and how rune works and how byte works. So let me show you an example right away. Let's write a small program of with print rune. Open terminal. So code test.go in a program and in a package main as usual. Func main, there we go. And let's start with a rune. So I'm gonna write it this way. A rune. Now let's do it this way. A rune, and it's a rune type equal, so single quotes and an A uppercase. So if I use my print rune function, and I put the A rune this way, this should work. Let's test it. After I saved, go run, test it, go. There you go, it works. Now, let's say I would like to print the character of a sentence, so of a string. So let's put string and single quotes, hello. There we go. The println function only accepts a rune. So here you have a mistake here. So let's say I would like to print the first letter. So in this case, the H. What I need to do is actually I need to access the first letter, which is at index 0 in this case. And this is still not a rune technically. And I need to cast it. So let's put the rune. Let's cast it. In this case, I need another parenthesis. This should work better. There you go. Let's go. H, the H is working. So let's say I wanted to print the whole world. So what I need to do in this case will be to repeat the action and change the change the zeros with the right index. So actually, I have to do it one by one. 2, 3, 4, and there we go. We should have the whole sentence, the whole world printed. Hello. So as you can see, there's a repetition of the action. Maybe you could write a function in this case for training purposes and for you to play with this program that will replace that repetition. Maybe you could use a loop, for example. I don't know. There you go. So that's it for the println function. And that was a very small example, but this is what you can do with it. Thank you very much and see you next time.